Hey, what's up everyone? Welcome back. So if you guys were paying attention to the end of my last video, I told you guys we had a couple things that I did not do. So the first thing I said we were gonna go is back here, and we'll go to right here where Straight Sal is. Or help me. I don't believe he can. He's the only one. He could help me like get boss souls and stuff. Because they both give you, I think, do they give you different boss souls? I'm not sure. But, different weapons. Let's use this. Let me concentrate really quick, because these things ain't no joke. Well, they're not even doing nothing now. Bought the bow, the dragon's bow, which I've been using. Oh, what is this? Armor of the Forlorn. Sweet. I got a little bit of money. Oh, I got enough for this too. Let's see what the Armor of the Forlorn is all about. Didn't I just buy it? Gauntlets of the who wandered the land of the undead. Born of Aldia's obsession with the first sin, the Forlorn lost both their corporeal form and a world to call their own. Now they drift into other worlds, even in search of a home. But without self has one neither beginning nor end, and so the Forlorn have only to wander. Right. A Drangalek. They're not that cool. Oh well, anyways. Now we gotta cross the bridge right here. See what's up here. Oh, those fucking archers aren't here no more. Ah, oh, poor guys. There used to be, oh, there's one of them. There used to be three archers that used to spawn right there that would fuck you up every time you spawn. Can't believe they took them away. That was Dark Souls. That was as Dark Souls as Dark Souls as get. Fucking so hardcore. No. Down. I actually know a cool little trick about right here. I'll show you guys. It's not only a good way to get some souls, but it's a good way to beat this area. What is this? Oh, Lucatiel. Nice. So what you do first is you set this off. And now there's a hole right there. Now if you come over here, there's gonna be some enemies you're gonna have to fight. Oh fuck! I didn't know. Blossom Night Shield. There used to be some other enemies down here. I don't remember what their names were called, but little secret right here. Make sure you want to get. Northern Ritual Band. Let's see what that is. What the hell happened to my... Oh, I took off my life ring. One of the secret treasures restored. Increases spell uses, but at the cost of XP. Increases poise, huh? Well, I guess those dudes are not here no more. Tis a shame. They should have added that fool and kept the other guys. Why am I so fucking happy? Oh, that's why, because I'm wearing the wrong gloves. Man, it's fucking dark in here. What does it say? Try attacking? Fig. Oh no. Oh, Mira. And Lucatiel, that fool just whipped that fool's ass. Oh, the High Knight Spear. Fuck yeah. Fire Seed. Uh-oh. Nothing. Am I still heavy? Yep. All right, so pretty much the whole reason why I had skipped this area and forgot about it is because you're actually supposed to go and get the key first, the Bastille key, which you get from fighting the gargoyles, I believe. I think that's where I got it from, but anyway, so you get the Bastille key, and if you don't get that key, this area is a hell of a lot harder, let me tell you. So you get the Bastille key and you're able to do this shortcut right here, which I don't know what kind of shortcut it is, but you come over here, and on this other side there's a boss battle, and this boss relies on the darkness. So without the Bastille key, which if I didn't have it, I couldn't do this right now. I'll show you guys. One of these flame butterflies you get throughout the game. Smooth silky stone. You gotta set these this oil. Set them on both sides. Now we can go and fight this Perseon. Repair powder. All right, let's do this. So I don't know if you guys noticed that, but there was like a bug in this, whatever the hell this thing's eye is. It sounded like a girl, but there's a lot of speculation saying that this is the Witch of Izalith or whatever from the first game of Dark Souls. Because there was actually the witches, which were the sisters, they were like daughters and stuff. The daughters, which was those ugly, Well, anyways, they were pretty much bosses and witches from the first game, and a lot of people think this is a lost sinner, which is actually a reincarnation or the actual witch from the game, because like they imprisoned her from trying to light the first flame, which in the first game that's what they were scarred, her family was scarred for doing, because they tried to light the first flame with Gwyn, and it ended up freaking turning everybody into demons and killing everybody. They actually made that fight a lot easier, and with the light. See, I lit the lights right there. See, they came in, and now, like, because otherwise it would be dark as hell in this room. And when she's dark, she's a lot stronger, but in the light, she's a lot weaker. Or he. She, I don't know what the hell it is. But fragrant branch of yore, nice. Liar ahead. Somebody probably had a sign saying that there's things, because there ain't nothing in this room. Primal bonfire, that's what it's called. All right. Alright, so back to Majula we go. Let's go ahead and level up.
The soul, your soul has grown strong. I only hope it brings you what you wish.
My soul has grown stronger. So I did intelligence, now I'm up to 10. Go to 12, huh? Since I'm a predator, I gotta have my shoulder cannon, right? Just unlocked it right now. Alright, so since I haven't done my attunement yet, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to substitute this ring right here, and it's going to for the southern ring, and now I have one. What the hell? Now I can shoot one magic. Bam, son! Bam! Bam! You gotta attune spells and then you're able to do it. I should probably put it on my left hand and replace. Should I do the claw for this? Nah, because I'll never use the claw. The claw is like a finishing move. I pull it out of my left hand and run and stab people. I didn't buy, my little brother asked if I bought the sorcerer's staff. I didn't buy it. I actually found it. You can find it in the beginning of the game. If you want to go back, if you guys haven't found where you get the sorcerer's staff, you can actually go back in the beginning of my episodes. It's like, I don't know what episode it is. Like, it's got to be early on in the videos. Yeah, that's much better. Much better, but now I'm heavy, so that's not good. I'm barely heavy too. These are all better, but they make me heavy. Alright, so the next place where actually the dude is wearing my mother freaking pants. We gotta go back here, which was the next area. The Huntsman's Copse. Undead Lockaway. Where was it at? It's in the beginning of the level. Alright, so we got one more boss to take care of. Hopefully I can end it in this video, because that one is a little bit tricky compared to the last one. The last one was pretty straightforward. You just have to dodge her attacks. But this one, a little bit harder. And like I said last time, this dude right here, if you...
Leave me
hook up both intelligence and faith, and you have it a certain amount, you'll be able to talk to him, and he'll give you access to dark spells. Damn, I've got a sword. Them zombies are getting smarter. Oh, I think I went a little bit too far back. No! Oh my god, I almost freaking ran off the edge. Yep. Alright, luckily we have the shortcut right here. So it's actually the middle bonfire, bridge approach. So you come here. And in my last video, some dude invaded me and I just ran straight. I think I just ran through here, if I'm not mistaken. I did talk to the main guy we had to talk to, so that's cool. What was his name? So it starts with a C. I can't remember the name of him right now. Instead of going left, you go to the right this time. Yeah, my little brother made a good point. He said he's never seen that weapon that they used before. I think you maybe be able to get it. Oh shit, our old friend the skeleton. I remember him from the first Dark Souls. I was where I was not supposed to be and he was letting me know that. So this is actually a pretty cool weapon right here, the notched whip. It actually caused bleeding. I'll show you guys what it is. It's this one right here. The notched whip. Yeah, it's basically a regular whip, my brother said, but has spikes on it. My little bro, Zach for life. He's giving us all this useful knowledge today. Ah, I'm a predator, bitch. Destroyed that fool. That's actually pretty cool. If you look at them, you could actually shoot it how you want without aiming. Because the closer I go, that means that a bunch of people would come to attack me. And I don't want that. Yeah, because then like four people. See, look, they're all up on the edges. So what you can do is... you can shoot them with the bow. Or shoot them with magic, or shoot them with anything. Throw a knife at them, or walk. If you walk forward slowly, they will come one at a time. But you can set off like two of them, and then you're gonna have a bad day. It's always good to have life gems on you, so you don't waste your actual stuff. Look, and there's actually something down here that we're gonna be getting on our way out of here. Be careful on this bridge, yo. I ran through here and I've died. Oh, what the hell? Oh, motherfucker! Well, I ran past the parts where I could die. My brother said I just told everyone not to run and then I ran. But you can't run through the parts right there. See, there's missing things on the ground. And look at they have all kinds of traps now, Zachary. They sent one of those guys that you have to fight on the bridge after you. What is it called? Damn, that fool. Oh shit. That fool's wrecking me. Reckon me. Oh, his poison's too much. I have to run away. See all those fucking things right there? You could die. Oh, I shot him in the butt. Oh, and then I shot him in the face. Oh, and then I shot him in the throat. Oh, and then I shot him in the hip. Oh, in the shoulder. I love the bow, man. I used to use the bow a lot in the first Dark Souls 2. No, not the Dragon Rider bow, just the bow. Yeah. Alright, buddy, now it's time to die. Ah! I got blood on my combat blade, combat wrist blade. That was a good idea to my brother. He's the one who said I should use my blade, my mannequin's claw. Huh. Alright, so here it is, guys, the moment of truth. What should I use? I guess I should use this weapon so that way nothing gets close to me. This is the dude that's wearing my pants and my shoes. Hello, hello. What the hell? Oh my god, what is that? Ah, idiot! That's horrible. It sucks being a lackey. A piece. That dude's wearing my pants. Alright, so don't worry too much about the skeletons, because you can't do nothing about them yet. Oh no! You gotta worry about the chariot and these dudes. What you can do is you can just use the chariot against them. Look, the chariot's coming. Here's the chariot. And then now I can go and kill this dude. Because if you don't kill that mage, then the skeletons just keep getting up. Alright, so next. Go to the next area. You gotta keep doing that in like three different areas. So just make sure you know what's going on. Oh shit, there's a skeleton right there. Damn, there's a bunch of them skeletons right here. Damn, I keep quick rolling. You could actually get under the chariot, but I keep messing up. Oh, here we go. They actually, see, now they can once, because if you don't kill those mages, they'll just keep getting up, but now they're going to die for reals. Alright, so there's a couple ways you can do this now. I could hide in the corner and keep shooting him every time he comes around the edge. Oh. Or I could just close the door on him, and that's what I'm going to do, because he's an asshole. No. Where's the damn switch at? Oh, there it is. Bam! Now I gotta put this horse out of his misery. What the hell? No. Now I gotta put the horse out of his misery. This is the more epic way to fight him. Oh, you fucker. Brother wants me to crush him with the doors. I don't think I could do that because he broke the door that closes. Oh, I hit the one on the right. I got him. He's not too hard. Oh, I guess I take that back. I'm sorry. Damn! That was fucking close. Mad as fuck now. I'm gonna die. Oh yeah, I'm dead. Fuck you! Fuck! Fuck you! Oh, I should have just killed him the other way. Cause the other way you just hide in the corner, and every time he comes around the corner, you shoot him in the face with a, you shoot him in the face with a bow, and then he, at the end of the, like after a while, he can't jump over the thing anymore, and he just falls, and you walk up and kick him over, and he falls into the pit. Yeah, but it's cool. That was a lot more epic. See, he would have just fell exactly like that. He would have not made it right here and crashed, and I would have walked over and hit him, and he would have fell in there. But at least I gave him an honorable death. Alright, so this place is pretty cool, you guys. So first things first, you're gonna notice this dude right here.
What is it? Oh, you trot along home. This place won't be any fun. Not for you. What is it? Oh.
Well, this dude is actually a covenant, but I forgot how you're supposed to, what you're supposed to do to talk to him. Undead Purgatory. You talk to the covenant, and then you're able to join these rooms right here, and these are like almost like multiplayer lobbies. You can join into other people's games, other people's, not other people's, but they put you in an arena and you fight people. So how the hell do I talk to this guy? I forgot.
What is it? Oh, you trot along home.
Oh yeah, I think you have to be undead or something. Oh. Maybe, I don't know. I can't kill myself right now. But anyways, what? My little brother wants me to kill myself.
That's probably why.
Yeah, so let's see. If I kill myself, my little brother, how many? I got two. I don't know if I should waste it. Alright, I did that in the name of science. Now let's see if I could talk to him. the hell? My phone's tripping. Alright, so let's see if we could talk to him now.
What is it? Oh.
I don't know. My little brother made me waste. Freaking thing. I forgot what you have to do to talk to him, but... No, it's alright. Alright, well anyways guys, that's going to be the end of this video. I hope you guys enjoyed. We got two boss battles. I went over the time a little bit, but only because I ended up killing myself for no reason. Get my blood stained back. But I forgot what name of that covenant is. It's like the, I know that fool loves blood, like, and the more people you kill, the more stuff he gives you, and you could buy stuff to invade other people, and you could also get his outfit. So, but anyways, I'm gonna go ahead and end this video, everyone. So I hope you guys enjoyed. Like my video up, subscribe to my channel. Till next time, everybody, peace.